Are you exploring new no-code tools? Well, one that you might want to consider is Triggre. I hadn't heard about Triggre until I got back from No-Code Paris in 2023, and apparently a lot of folks are using it. So in this video, I want to take my first glance, almost do an unboxing of Triggre for you, and walk through the different components that I find fascinating, take a look at their pricing model, all of that. So if that's of interest, stick around. And let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth, and this is Gap Consulting, and we make it our mission to help you to get the most out of your no-code tools. I want to help you so that you can build just about anything you can imagine using no-code technology. And in this video, as I mentioned, we're going to be taking a first look at Triggre. But before we actually get into Triggre itself, I first want to invite you to join me for some automation training. Regardless of what tool you're using in no-code, if you can master the key building blocks of no-code automation, you are going to save countless hours. And I want to help you do exactly that in my free training that you can get at gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration. Go ahead and sign up there and check out that training. But without further ado, let's go ahead and hop on into Triggre. I would encourage you to follow along. And also, if you do decide to go with Triggre, go ahead and use our affiliate link. It will send some love back to the channel and help us to continue to do more videos like this. All right. So first and foremost, what in the world is Triggre? I'm going to be completely real with you. I really haven't looked at the software itself yet. This is my first glance. Now, that being said, I have met with their team because I had some questions and all of that. And one thing that they shared with me that I absolutely love is they stress the importance of understanding your process before you try to build something. And this is absolutely critical to any tool that you ever use in no code. I don't care what the tool is, if you try to build something and you don't know what you're building, you're gonna be disappointed. So I really have to say just off the get-go that I'm really vibing with what Triggre's team is bringing to the table here, because they are really stressing the most important factor, which is nail your process and then our software is gonna help you do it. All right, so like many of the no-code tools, they are saying, look, our technology, our software is gonna help turn your manual tasks into your digital tool. And so it's giving me a lot of automation vibes, which is of no surprise. So we've got automating processes, saving time and money, and improving our business. Now, the first place I always like to go, I'll be real, is just right to the pricing page. I want to know, what are the different plans? What are the prices? And what am I going to get? What's the value that I'm getting from the software? So I'm going to scroll on down here to what looks like their three tiers plus the enterprise quote. This tends to be pretty common inside of the no code, software right now. We get that free tier, then, the personal type of use, the smaller paid plan. Then we get into the third tier here, the more expensive business-esque plan. And then lastly, we have that enterprise level. And I also have it on good authority that a lot of Triggre's current client base is at that business and enterprise level. So I'm not saying that they're not a good fit for the small personal use, but chances are you're going to be looking at this for some sort of a business process, something more advanced, more complex. So what is that? Okay. Notice that the thing that they're selling here, and I should point out, this is a European country, but we can obviously put this in US dollars, but the thing that they're selling here is actions. And so again, this is giving me some real automation vibes. They are selling actions, moving data throughout this system. And so we've got a $50 a month US, a $200 a month US, and we're going with 2000 actions versus 50,000 actions. And this seems to be pretty much on point for the different, tiers that we might use automation in. If we're doing things personally, 2000 is very normal. And if we're doing things professionally, 10, 20, 50,000 is very normal. So what are we getting here? All right, we've got user interface templates, so we can create applications with the user interface designs. That's awesome, because who doesn't love getting up and running quickly with a template? Number two, we have our automation interval. So if we're on the free plan, it's an hour. If we're on an advanced or a personal plan, it's 15 minutes, and it gets faster the more money we're spending, the higher tier that we're on. We get Zapier integrations, okay? We have custom web APIs, even on the free version. That's amazing. Basic performance, and then this performance is going to tier up as we go through. So basic, standard, standard, and premium. And then we get community support on the free plan. And when we upgrade to business, it looks like we're getting that email support. So email support from Triggre's team and all of that. Now, if we're looking to get onto the more advanced customization things, those custom settings are going to be on paid plans only. Backups. This is something that people ask about a lot inside of no-code. It looks like backups are a part of the personal plan. And when we want to start doing custom URLs, daily backups, and also including payment services, I mean, provide payments in your application for your customers using Stripe. This is obviously a business use case, so it makes sense to me that it's going to be on that business plan or that business tier at $200 a month. Okay, so now that we have an understanding of, you know, what's coming out of Triggre with the different pricing, let's go back just to the homepage, and I want to go back to, you know, kind of the flow of a new client coming here. First thing is we see the start for free or book a free demo. And if we scroll down, we're going to see all the time and money that people are saving with Triggre. Is this a Zapier-like product? Is this a Make-like product? Is this an Airtable-like product? I have a feeling that it's going to be including a little bit of everything. So let's get into the start it for free. I'm going to go ahead and sign up for a Triggre account. As you can see, I've not done this before. I'm going to give it my email address and let's hop in. All right, I'm going to sign up here. Continue. And yes, I'm in the US. And okay, so the very first thing it's saying is, what are we calling your application? This is going to be gapconsulting.triggre.net. Thankfully, it's available. They're collecting a lot of information. I got to say, I like the feel of this, the way that I've got this on the side, and then I'm answering the different questions in here. I'm hopeful that the same feel is still inside of the application once I'm all set up. Where is consulting services? I'm not seeing it. Let's go software and IT services. And I will click on continue. And I am interested in other, let's just say project management. I'm curious to see if it actually recommends some project management stuff to me. All right, so interestingly, once I get to this page, I've got an automatically playing video from Jesse, the founder of Triggre. I kind of like this, to be honest with you. They're talking about getting started the right way. A lot of what I had already mentioned at the beginning, making sure that you plan out your process before you start building. And he's also telling a little bit of the story about what Triggre is and how they came into existence. I like this. I'll let you watch the video when you're setting it up yourself. I'm going to skip for now and let's see where we go on the next page. We are already just building our application in Triggre. So I'm thinking that it's a little bit different from an Airtable or a Smart Suite in that we have one application that we're building versus doing something like an Airtable or a Smart Suite where we have so many different types of environments, of different solutions that we can create. And here in Triggre, it looks like we're just going to have that one. It's taking a little bit of time to build, but I'm guessing it's going to be pretty robust. Now that my application has been built for me, it's asking me to set up my password for my account. I can just choose a random password. And let's go ahead and confirm. And once we're done, oh, I have to add a capital letter. Let me do that. Add that. And oh boy, special character. Here we go. All right. Now that I've got my example password set up, I am going to be redirected now into another video, Jesse again. I'm not going to watch this one. Let's click out and go okay. And I got to say, I like the feeling of this because I like these self-guided tutorials. Like, I just loaded the software. I just built my own application. Obviously, it's not doing a lot yet, but it looks like Triggre has put a lot of effort into the educational components of the tool, which is fantastic. As I am onboarded into the product, I'm going step by step and learning all about it. So I've got the basics. Yes, I'll come back to that, I'm sure. I've got templates that I can install. And if I need help, support is right here. And then, of course, settings for my application using the settings button. And we're all good. So if I click into basics, exercises built right into the platform to teach me the different components. And I can also go down to the lab. This is telling me from the dashboard I can visit the application after I publish it. Great. And of course, design is where I will build the application. where I'll publish it, and lastly, the different versions. So this is something that's unique to Triggre, is that I can go back in time and see the various versions of my application. This is very unique in no code because generally in no code, when we build something and we make updates, that's it. It's now the same version, all one version now updated. And so it looks like Triggre actually stores access, a history of previous versions of our app, which is really, really helpful. All right, clicking OK from here, we're going to also see that we can log out up here. All right, that's it. And here's a little demo on versions. Fantastic. And let's get into the templates. I want to see the templates. Unfortunately, this is one of those components about self-guided learning, especially with software. It's a love-hate relationship I have. On one hand, I want to see this. I want to learn this. On the other hand, it's like, let me poke around. I want to figure it out myself. So, okay, I can save different versions. That's awesome. Version one, let's save it. And there we are. So I've just saved the first version of my application, which to the best of my knowledge doesn't do much of anything, but here we are. Now we've got it all saved. This is the most recent version of our app. That's awesome. I can download a design by clicking here. Very interesting, actually. And then I can click a version to load the design and then load that particular instance. And I can also remove it by clicking delete. All right. It's got a delete icon and I can now delete and wow. Okay. This is definitely very advanced in terms of the different components that it's allowed us to have inside of Triggre, because I can actually go in and create these different versions, delete things, update them, etc. Now, design is going to be a different component where I can choose the appearance. It looks like grayed out here is data, flow parts, automation flows, user flows, and appearance. There's a lot here. Now I want to actually get into the guts of the application itself. So I'm going to continue through the rest of this video tutorial, and I'm going to come back in this video when I've gotten through all of this training stuff. Now I've done quite a lot of clicking to get through the self-guided tutorial, and I'm on the other side of it now. And I want to just start some building. I want to start by loading a template and seeing what it does. What is it and how can I interact with it? So let's go ahead and kind of scroll through our different templates here, and I'll pick up this Berry back office. It's providing an easy to use self-service portal for employees managing benefits, et cetera, et cetera. Let's load it. So I'm going to load. And let's see where this takes me from here. Now that I've installed that template, I want to go and find it and actually interact with it. So I can click on design and down here pop the different components. I have my data. So Triggre is actually storing my information. I also have the flow components and automation flows, as well as the user flows and ultimately the appearance. So when I think about no code tools, they usually fall in three buckets: where I store my data, how I move my data, and how people interact with my data. And my instinct is to assume that Triggre is all three of these things. It's allowing me to store data in the data section. It's allowing me to move data. And then lastly, it's allowing me to impact how people interact with that data. So here's the appearance. I've got the template installed. I've got different user roles, it looks like, manager, employee, admin, and I can look at their different access. So I'm very curious, you know, how this all builds out as I work more and more in Triggre. But the part I really want to draw our attention to is the flow parts, because this is kind of unique to Triggre in how intuitively they share different flows through the business process. So let's say, for example, I wanted to accept expenses. This is a flow that's already been installed per the templates. And here we see that there's an input that leads to the expense calculator, right? And then we update the expense receipt, and that's it. There's no output. So this type of very easy to understand, you know, flow chart is becoming more and more popular inside of no code. And I love that Triggre is including it. Now, back up to automation flows, let's take a look at this. We can click on the plus here to add an automation flow, and we can add something to Triggre, either a connection Triggre, a data Triggre, or a scheduled Triggre, and build our automations right inside of the platform. So I'm interested how all of this comes about and what does it ultimately mean for you and building your own no-code application. Obviously, there's going to be a learning curve with any new platform, but is Triggre something you should consider? I kind of go back to the pricing. You know, what I'm seeing from their pricing is we are being charged for the actions, but in no way, shape, or form is Triggre charging us, at least not on this page, by charging us for the user. So if you're building something for many, many users, this might be a really helpful application for you. You don't have to worry necessarily about being charged for everybody that you add to your app. You can have the different roles, the different people within the organization or external, and you can share that application with them. Automations are running in the background. That's the whole key to no code. And you're getting it for a fixed price every month based on the actions that you're using. Pretty enticing. I'm really excited to explore Triggre in more detail. So let me know what you think about this video and if you're interested in learning more about Triggre. If so, I'll be sure to connect with them even further and put out more content about this tool. In the meantime, my friend, keep on building.